Greg, what can you tell us about what happened?
Yeah, so this morning, just after 9 o'clock, officers were called to the middle school here behind me on a reported cutting call for service. Upon their arrival, they located a male victim, a student at the school, inside suffering from apparent stab wounds. They immediately began performing life-saving measures along with security, who was already in the school. EMS was summoned to go ahead and come into the school. They did transport that victim to the hospital. That victim, last update, is life-threatening, critical condition. Officers did detain a subject of interest inside the school, another student, a juvenile here. There is no ongoing threat at this time inside the school. The school district officials are working with parents. They're sending out information to parents about how they can safely get here to pick up their student. But I want to reiterate, there is no ongoing threat at this school currently.
Can you share the age or grade of the victim?
I don't have the age right now, just that this is a male victim that goes to school here, and I know this is a middle school with 7th and 8th graders.
So 7th and 8th graders, a boy. And how about the person that has been
detained? The subject of interest is also a male student here.
And we don't know 7th or 8th grade?
We don't at this time.
Do we know what caused it? Is there a fight? Was there a beef?
That'll be part of the investigation for the detectives to work out. From what we can gather, there was some sort of confrontation that led up to this event. So, again, I want to reiterate that the students here are all safe. There's no ongoing threat, and the school district is working with the parents right now.
Can you describe the security procedures at the middle school level? I know high schools have extensive security, like metal detectors and such, but what about at middle school?
I don't know about this current middle school. That would be more a question for the school district here. I know that right now the school is currently still on lockdown, even though there's not an ongoing threat, so that we can safely get students with their parents, and they're going to be sending out those directions to parents if they haven't already on exactly what location and what entrance and all of that.
And are you preparing to dismiss students from the north entrance?
I don't know what entrance it will be for the school district to decide. They're coordinating with our detectives here, but they are going to dismiss for the day. I know that.
But as you mentioned, the important thing to note, no ongoing threat. No one else in danger at the moment.
Correct. And so any updates that we get on the condition of the victim, we will provide them as we receive them.
And the weapon you believe was a knife?
That is the information we're being told at this point, yeah.
Did you confiscate it?
I don't have any of those details to the investigation, so.
Okay. Yeah. Officer Donna Drake from the Kansas City, Missouri Police Department. Again, this reported to police just after 9 a.m. We now know that there was some sort of confrontation between two students, Kim and Nick, both boys. We know that this school teaches 7th and 8th graders, not sure about the age or what grade level these students were in, but it was either 7th or 8th. One boy did suffer life-threatening injuries. He had been treated initially by police and security personnel, now being treated at the hospital. The other boy has been detained by police for further questioning. So we'll send it back to you. As we get more information, we'll be sure to bring it to you.
Do you guys have any additional questions?
Sorry.
So we know it was a knife. We know it was two middle school boys. We know it's some sort of fight. We don't know if it was ongoing fight or if it was just
I don't know the specifics about what led up to the confrontation today, but obviously it was some sort of confrontation between the two.
We don't know how a knife got into the building.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Is there security here at the middle school?
I believe so, but that again would be a question for the school district. I believe there is security here.
But it might be different from what you'd see at the high school level.
Sure. I don't know about their security measures. I would reach out to the school district. But again, we're working with them to gather the information. I just spoke with one of their public information people. And so they have advised that they've sent out an email to parents. They're sending out another email just to give them specifics on what entrance or exit they're going to be exiting the students from.
Well, if you could get an age or grade level,
that
would be helpful.
Sure, yeah. I mean, we know it's at least 7th or 8th grade, so.
Right. Do we know where it happened? In the cafeteria, at the lockers, where in the school?
I believe it happened in a bathroom.
Oh, in a restroom, okay. Mm-hmm. Boys room.
Were they in class and changing?
Yeah, I don't know yet. Too early for that. The investigators are all breaking off into their assignments, and they're going to be working towards all that information. So,
how long has the school been on lockdown?
Well, we got the call just after 9 o'clock. I think exactly at 9:03 is when we got the 911 call.
Do you have any initial details as to who was notified about the incident in the restroom first? Was it security there first?
No, I think I think security heard some yelling, and that's what brought their attention to that area. But I don't know for sure.
Did Do you know if any KCPS PIOs will be on the scene? Or...
I don't know. I think they're going to be, I know they're going to be sending out information via email, and I know I talked to her, and she was going to be sending out something to you guys. I don't believe that she was coming over.
And you can't detail what kind of security they have there, if it's police officers walking the halls, if it's metal detectors, you don't know that.
I believe they have school security. I don't know what that is at this point. I think it's, again, I would direct you to them, but I don't want to guess, but I think it's KCPS, but I'm not sure.
Do you have a message at all to parents about incidents like these? I mean, we saw this a few weeks ago, but it was a shooting at Olympic mm-hmm. East, and it seems it's just happening with younger and younger students.
Yeah, I mean, this is scary. As a parent, to get that call or to see something come across your TV at your desk while you're working or you're at home working, have conversations with your kids, you know, about what to do in these types of situations, what to do if you're having conflict. Talk about conflict resolution, you know. We don't know all the details about what specifically happened in this case, but have that open line of communication with your students, with your kids, so that if they are having any problems with somebody at school, that they feel like they can come to you directly, maybe to resolve it. Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what hospital the victim's taken to?
I believe Children's Mercy, yeah.
And we know life-threatening injuries to that victim.
Yeah, I don't have an update on condition at this point.